Hi, I'm Lisa Elkin. I'm a fourth-year PhD student at the University of Washington, and today I'm going to be presenting my work called An Aligned Rank Transform Procedure for Multifactor Contrast Tests. And this is work I did with my wonderful co-authors, Matt Kay, James Higgins, and my PhD advisor, Jake Wobbrock. So in HCI, it's really common to use parametric tests to analyze our data. But when our data doesn't meet the assumptions of those parametric tests, we have to turn to nonparametric tests. And one really important assumption of parametric tests is that data has normally distributed residuals. So for data with non-normally distributed residuals, which we refer to as nonconforming data in our paper, one really common method to analyze that data is the aligned rank transform, or the ART. Now the ART has two steps, an alignment step followed by a ranking step. And after those two steps, any data can be analyzed with any omnibus test, which includes the ANOVA that we're all so familiar with. Now, the ART works really, really well for omnibus tests, and it also works well for contrasts between levels of one factor, but it doesn't work well for contrasts between levels of multiple factors. And a really important example of a contrast test are post hoc tests that we conduct all the time. So we created an example that we use throughout our paper, which we call our running example. And here, on our running example, we used the ART to conduct contrasts between combinations of levels of multiple factors. And you can see on the left that ART incorrectly found a difference between A1B2 and A1B1. And from the figure, it's very clear that there isn't a difference. And then on the right, ART failed to find a difference between A1B1 and A2B2. And again, from the figure, we can see that there is a significant difference. Now, you're probably not convinced by one example. I wasn't either. But we tested this with thousands of synthetic data sets, and we found that this pattern is true, that ART frequently finds differences that don't exist, and it frequently fails to find differences that do exist when it's used to conduct contrasts between combinations of levels of multiple factors. So we created a new method. It's called the Aligned Rank Transform Contrasts, or ARTC. Now, what's important about ARTC that is different than other nonparametric tests is that it still remains within the ART paradigm. It still has an alignment step followed by a ranking step, but the alignment step is different than the ART's alignment step. ARTC's alignment step specifically aligns data for the contrasts that are going to be performed. And because of this alignment step, as we'll show later, ARTC does work very well for conducting contrasts between combinations of levels of multiple factors. So you can see the math on this slide. I'm not going to go through it now, but take a look at our paper if you want to go through it in more detail. All right, so now I need you to believe me that our method worked. So we validated our method on 72,000 synthetic data sets. And to create those data sets, we varied different properties systematically, but randomly. We varied things like the type of distribution the data was drawn from, the number of samples per condition, the layout, was this 2x2 data, 3x3 data, whether the data was between or within subjects, etc. And we evaluated our method on two metrics, observed type 1 error rate and observed statistical power. And we did this because we followed common practice within the statistics literature. So observed type 1 error rate is defined as the proportion of tests in which a true null hypothesis was rejected. So we have a significance level alpha, and alpha is used as a threshold for whether or not to reject a null hypothesis. And we use alpha equals 0.05 all the time. So when p is less than 0.05, we reject a null hypothesis. And the observed type 1 error rate is just the proportion of tests in which the null hypothesis was rejected for a specific significance level over all the number of tests that were conducted. And we want the observed type 1 error rate to be close to alpha. So we want that ratio to be close to 0.05. And we compared ARTC to a t-test, again, because this is common practice in statistics. And you can see in the figure on the right, ARTC is in teal and the t-test is in gray. And of all of our different tests, they both have pretty good type 1 error rate. They're both pretty close to 0.05. When you look at the numbers, ARTC is a little bit more tightly packed around 0.05, which means it's a better method, but they both perform pretty well here. Except for, you can see the points in red are tests on data that were drawn from a Cauchy distribution, but a Cauchy distribution is known to be pathological, and many statistical methods break down when used to analyze data drawn from a Cauchy distribution, and we talk about this more in our paper. Okay, so ARTC doesn't find differences when they're not there, but that's only kind of useful. We still need it to find differences when they are there, and that's the observed statistical power. It's the proportion of tests in which a false null hypothesis was rejected. Now, unlike type 1 error rate, we don't have a threshold to compare to. We just want power to be good, and we want it to be larger or as large as other methods. And so we compared ARTC's statistical power again to a t-test. So you can see in this figure, ARTC is in teal on the bottom, the t-test is in gray in the middle, and we also compared to a Mann-Whitney U test and a Wilcoxon sign rank test. Those are two really common non-parametric methods that are used, Mann-Whitney U test for between subjects data and Wilcoxon sign rank test for within subjects data. And so you can see here between all of the different population distributions that ARTC has higher power than the other methods, and that's because the histogram is shifted to the right. Now, when you look at this figure, yeah, it has higher power, but it doesn't look like it's that much higher. But when you think about it, even a small difference really, really matters. So if ARTC correctly finds a difference in 60% of the cases, and another method only finds a difference, a true difference in 40% of the cases, and you are using this difference to analyze your data for your experiment, that 20% difference actually really, really matters. And so we see that ARTC has low type 1 error rate clustered around 0.05, and it has high statistical power. In order to enable people to use ARTC, we extended two existing open source tools for ART. One is the ARTool Windows application that enables people who don't know how to use R to still use ART and now ARTC. We've added this want contrast box that users can tick, and after the data has been aligned and ranked for ART, they can select which factors levels they'd like to conduct contrast between, and the data will be aligned and ranked for those contrasts. We've also extended the ARTool R package. As before, users create an ART model and run an ANOVA on that ART model. And now we've added this ART.con function so that users can conduct ART contrasts with one extra line of code. All of this is available online, the ARTool R package, the code for the R package, at that third link, the ARTool Windows application and the code for it are also available. And we've put all of the code that we use to generate synthetic data, run simulations, and analyze results online. All of these links are also in our paper. And at that bottom link, we've also included a nice R markdown document that explains everything we did in the paper, but in a more approachable way that might be useful for some people who are less familiar with statistics. In summary, we created the ARTC algorithm, validated it on 72,000 synthetic datasets, and we extended the ARTool R package and Windows application. Thank you so much for watching, and now a real-time version of me will be happy to answer any questions you might have.